Alrighty guys, Thursday, May 18th out here. Driving back from the North Farm, got inside dressed. Pretty windy out. Today's not quite as bad, but yesterday and Tuesday and some Monday, it's just blowing like nothing else. The windmills are going. Almost looked like it was gonna just rain the whole day, and it was kind of foggy looking just from all the dust. It was real bad. Saw a bunch of Jeff Raymond's dirt blowing by yesterday afternoon, come up from Southern Illinois, and you guys in Michigan, Michigan Farming, and Scott Byers and Dryden Green, Josh Timer. Be on the lookout tomorrow for my dirt. Will probably be up around your area, so. Wind was definitely blowing. Not a whole lot of action out here right now. We come up and plant. There is, I bet almost everybody was out running around here. A couple guys side dressing when I come up yesterday around here. There's another guy out there working ground. Kind of come down off the ridge here. It's kind of the line here from the good dirt, and then it kind of gets marginal dirt up here once you get up on this ridge. And it just kind of stays at a higher elevation. I don't think it ever really comes down as you get up towards over into Indiana and up, kind of head up around up north there. But we got a 475-acre side dress. If I could have till about tomorrow afternoon without rain, or mid-afternoon without rain, I think I could be done side dress, at least our own ground, and then be ready to move on to the custom work. For those of you who don't know, we do custom side dressing. Local fertilizer dealer pays us come in and side dress because they're busy spraying and everything else, and they got several farmers do that for them. Works out pretty good. They got our salesman is in with a farm that VTO's farm over 10,000 acres probably, and they like it, most of it side dressed, because that makes several thousand acres of side dressing for us and a couple other farmers to all get over, so it works out pretty good. That's kind of a rare sight right there, a John Deere in this country. Shaft implement we deal with, Versatile stuff, and they used to be a white dealer until AGCO pulled the contract away. They're over in that area, and I'll drive by them here in a little bit. But John Deere is a minority in this area. I'll tell you, Versatile tractors, I bet they outnumber four-wheel drives anyway. The Versatile outnumber John Deere 3-1. And I didn't realize how many there were out in this area until this spring, because we don't get up in this area much unless we're going up to our north farm. I'm driving around on the way up there, and everybody's out in the field, and there were about a dozen Versatiles running, and there are only one or two John Deeres running. You know me, I gotta mention that. I don't like John Deere, but try to catch some crap for that in the comments. got the baler painted this past week, right before we got back in the field. Got it all painted and tried it out. The only thing I got left to do is put decals on it, but I got it painted all put back together and everything. I got the decals, I just need to put them on. Probably do that this weekend if it rains. And I got videos painting it. I just didn't want to. I hadn't finished making the videos for it yet, since I wanted to show the finished product. But I strung six bales out in the yard and made a windrow out of them, and went and baled it up. And it baler worked great. Did a nice job and everything. And I would like try it out after I had it, or you know, worked on it and whatnot, just make sure everything's gonna work good. And with the strung them out in the yard and thought, like, I had the 880 on it and thought, man, this thing's taking a lot of power to run. And well, it seemed like it was working really hard at the hay. And then I got done baling up the six bales, and I went back behind the baler and looked, and I only had three bales. So kind of why it was working hard. I wasn't even thinking when I tightened the thing down, I made turned six bales into three bales. But it did work good. Knotter worked good. Got new chains on it. But I'll come back to you. Go by the toy store here in a minute. Sitting right there. Kind of weird to see one that's actually put together. And then up here on the right, we got an open station 2150 hooked up to Haybine. Big tractor for that hay bind. Like I said, it's a disc bind, but still. Well, proceed to root. Sitting around. About all the versatile tractors are out on lease or reduce their inventory this winter, which is good. Don't want to be sitting on a lot of equipment with grain prices the way they are. He started out a Minneapolis dealer, then they picked up the Oliver contract in like 70 or 71. And then obviously it became a white dealer then, and then their AGCO dealer all the way up until a couple of years ago. AGCO, they weren't selling enough stuff, I guess, because they were kind of more in the New Holland combine market for combines and versatile tractors. They sold some white planters, but about it. So they pulled the contract away, which I never makes sense to me. It was a stupid move on AGCO's part. Because now no one's going to want AGCO anything in this area. But they got picked up New Holland back in 87, because when Versatile sold out to Ford in 87, they were a Versatile dealer, and they were still wanting a, man, they really have cleaned up a lot. They must have everything out on lease, or renting it out, or whatever. Well, when Versatile sold out to Ford, they bought the Ford dealership, which is a couple miles over this way. So they could have the Versatile contract, and then along with that, they got New Holland, and now they mainly sell New Holland. So, kind of how that happened. But those of you that are still watching my rambling here, thanks for watching. And Dan Whiteford, I got a video for you. I haven't made it yet. I'll probably make it tomorrow. Another video coming up with the pylon camera and hopefully the drone if the wind dies down, but I don't know if that's going to happen. So, thanks for watching.